Well, it looks like Halo Infinite has once again got hit with more bad news, which is also not really that much of a surprise at this point. I mean, based on what we're getting with Halo Infinite and all that jazz, like especially with split screen and so on. But so yeah, how's it going, everyone? Hope y'all been having a really good day so far. My name is Ward, and welcome back to the Gaming Entertainment Hub. And today, it looks like Halo Infinite has made another scrap app, and of course, that scrap is going to be taking away the seasonal cutscenes following the 343 layoffs, or reshuffle and all that jazz. And basically, like, the seasonal cutscenes that usually come with every season, and that's related to what we're going to be playing, the multiplayer and all that jazz. So basically, for those who actually really enjoy this, especially if you're fans of the Halo lore like I've always been. So yeah, this is very disappointing news. And so yeah, without any further ado, as always, let's go ahead and dive right into the reasoning behind this. So, for starters, it says that Halo Infinite has scrapped its story-driven seasonal cutscenes. The news comes after the significant layoffs at developer 343 Industries earlier this year. And in a tweet below, the community director Brian Jarrod, also known as Sketch, explains 343 made the trade-off to make further gameplay improvements instead of the new story content for Halo Infinite. But well, at least that's going to be good for something because, after waiting for nearly 2 years, we finally get like some like infection mode, which is a feature that should have been in the game at launch, in my opinion. So he states that in the tweet, saying, "As we refine our top priorities and shift the resources internally this year, we had to make the decision to forego seasonal narrative cutscenes to make room for the team. Need to continue focusing on the highly requested features, content, and improvements for Halo Infinite." Excuse me. Let's see, I'll just. "So these trade-offs are never easy to make, and we truly appreciate your support as the team works to make Halo Infinite the best experience possible. And while the job is far from over, Season 4 marks another big step forward, and we remain committed to this journey with the Halo community." And so yeah, I guess I did it again. So yeah, this is what he says right there, and then the mention of the shifted resources may refer to the layoffs affected by 343 earlier this year, and saw Halo Infinite's director Joseph Staten leave the developer, leave as well. And while prioritizing gameplay, it has been heralded by some community members in Jarrod's replies. Some who enjoy Halo story were left feeling upset over part of the two-decade-old franchise being left behind. It was forced to clarify that Halo, and Master Chief are here to stay, following the layoff, saying that it will continue to develop, well, will continue to develop Halo now and in the future, including epic stories, multiplayer, and more of that, yada yada yada. So yeah, good luck with that after firing the campaign team in the made, which is like the only, in my opinion, was like the only good thing, only reason why I got into playing Halo Infinite in the first place was mainly the campaign. Like, sure, yeah, sure, looking at it, it does have its flaws, odds, and all that stuff. And in fact, dude, the fact is, like I think, like, two-thirds of the game of what I was playing, the campaign, was cut out, which is like, I believe, probably even more than in what was cut from the third act from Halo 2, ooh, those many years ago. So yeah, 343 is working on a new Halo project codenamed Tatanka, but built in Unreal Engine 5 rather than using their Source-based engine, yada yada. So yeah, hey, this could actually be like, the Battle Royale mode that we've been like, talking about out. And so right now, everything's like curling up in the air at this point. And so yeah, yeah, personally for me, like, I didn't really like, wasn't really that invested into these seasonal cutscenes. But the fact that they just like, make another scrap with add to the lore is just not really that surprising. And especially like, this is a habit that 343 Industries like seems to like to make with their writing decisions, such as like when they first, way back in the days when they first acquired the franchise and set up the foundation for Halo 4, saying, "Okay, Chief wakes up from cryo sleep, and then now you come against the Prometheans and the Didact, and now out there." And of course, when you transition to Halo 5, I've none of this elements that was established in Halo 4 didn't even carry over to that, but all that ended up getting, most of that got concluded in like a series of comic books and novels, such as, oh, look, at the end of Halo 4, defeat the Didact, and then you can also find him again in the comic books, and now he's been proposed at some point, and now they're just gonna like now they're gonna officially let in the story arc of the Didact in a form of a novel, which will be coming out probably like, several months from now, as of the making of this video and now. And basically, yep. And at the start of Halo 5, they just took everything that they established in Halo 4 and Spartan Ops and just swept it under the rug and then say, oh, look, guys, we got a new threat called the Created, which was established by Cortana magically coming back to life. And now she's an evil dictator taking over the entire galaxy and then transition her to Halo Infinite. They just swept that under the rug. And now we gotta fight the Banished, and now they're gonna establish like a new faction that has always been in the Halo universe, but they just never recorded in history, known as the Endless. And now that they got rid of the campaign team, like far most of the campaign team, and also even like the contractors as well, which is personally for me, thank God that I did not even get one of those positions, because a little fun fact, I was actually interviewed for one of those contracting positions, but didn't really get those many years ago. But the fact that they actually got laid off, man, I can't. I'm glad that I managed to dodge the bullet, especially like the fact that they would moved me into Seattle, which is like a not a great city, a city I would not recommend living in, to be honest. And so yeah, that's kind of like my little rant right now. Like, sure, it kind of sucks that they're actually making even more scraps with Halo Infinite, especially like last year when they announced that, oh, sorry, we're not gonna have split screen anymore, despite promising that every new Halo game after Halo 5 will have split screen, as like officially established by Bonnie Ross back in 2017, and then didn't like make it at launch, and they say, oh, we can't do that anymore. Then yeah, I don't know what's going up on right now, but hopefully, things could actually change for the better. But personally, I'm not really getting my hopes up. But although I'm sure that season 4 will actually, will be a great to experience, and even I will try. Maybe I'll play around with it every once in a while and just try out the infection mode at some point. And but personally, I don't know. In my opinion, as much of an optimist as I am with the. Try to stay optimistic over the last 10 years of the Halo franchise, despite some of the shortcomings of 4 and 5, and especially like how they mismanaged Halo Infinite. Really hurts to say it, but I'm just not really feeling that enthusiastic right now. But it could actually come back, if they actually do make another Halo game in Unreal Engine 5, but only time will tell. But I guess I will definitely cover news on the Halo franchise. It's because, hey, that's what I'm supposed to do, and that's like the entire reason why I made this channel and so on. And so, but yeah, enough with the rambling and the ranting right now. But that's gonna be it for today's video, guys. If you found it to be helpful and informative, then be sure to drop a like as always, and subscribe for more content like this. You want to get to speed on any upcoming Halo news and all that jazz, and hit the bell to be notified whenever my next video is going to drop, and got your own thoughts or opinions based on this recent decision of scrapping all the seasonal cutscenes that's supposed to expand on the lore in Halo Infinite and all that jazz. And well, go ahead and sound off in the comment section below and get a discussion going, because I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. And again, thank you so much for watching, and we'll catch you all in the next one.